over here at my complex, apartment complex. So I got a Mr. Richard. So we got the little boards to for the ramp, so we get that mower up in that up in the bed of the truck, guys. So I don't know, I kind of like doing this, working out of the truck. It's a lot more efficient. I don't have to carry that big old trailer or whatnot. So Mr. Richard took care of that complex right behind me there, guys. Pretty nice. Bien, man. Bien. Gracias. Looking good, man. Looking good, bro. There we go. There we go. We got that steel, that 450. Let's see if Richard can. There you go. That's it, buddy.
So, ¿cómo fue el día, güey?
Oh, güey. Muy bien, muy bien.
Muy bien. Oh, no se dice güey. Como, what's up, dude? What's up, man? No. Güey.
Güey.
Güey, like.
Tell me if y'all like this stand-on mower. Check it out. That's my stand-on mower. This is the Honda HRX 217. There it is. Bought it at a local dealership here. This is here, let's, I guess we get a better look at it real quick. So you got the control, the speed control here, then of course this engages the transmission, blade control. This one I believe is the 9.5 horsepower or something engine. So that's gonna be my my main mower for now. As you guys already know, I got all my equipment jacked, and so little by little I'm getting. I was using borrowed mowers and equipment. Not only did I just purchase this today, but also went ahead and purchased the Steel FS 91 trimmer, line trimmer, and the BG 86 handheld mower, or handheld blower, I'm sorry. And I do have just wanted to give a special shout out to a couple of people real quick. And these are people that helped me purchase this stuff, believe it or not. It was crazy. First of all, I just wanted to give a shout out to my buddy David over at David's Tree and Lawn Service in Odessa, Texas. Man, that dude went way and beyond to help a brother out, man. And it was crazy because I didn't ask, you know what I'm saying? Well, what he did was he made a GoFundMe, and he collected some money for me to get back on my feet, right? Of course, I didn't ask him until after the fact, and he was like, "Hey, dude, I got some money for you. Give me your bank account, and we'll go from there, right?" So I was like, "What?" But he did, and here's a couple of names that I kind of want to mention. Dow Gentry, he contributed. Roger Zumwalt, Eduardo Castillo, Money Making Mike G, that's my boy right there. Benjamin De La Cruz, Juan Romero from Romero Lawn Service, Victor Vasquez, and I want to also give a special shout out to Matt, Lawn Care Little Guy. He also did a video to help, I guess, ask if you guys wanted to contribute to the GoFundMe page. Like I mentioned, I never did ask David for to do this or anything, or anybody. This was after the fact. He collected the funds. So, man, much props to Matt for also helping out, and David. But also, I want to recognize special person, Eddie from Fast Eddie's Lawn Care out of Houston. This is Eddie. What's up?
Yes. How's it going?
What? He drove all the way, what, like 3 hours?
A little over 3 hours.
A little bit over 3 hours to bring me that. Here, let me see. Let's see if I can pick it up. Yeah. Bring me this steel. What is it, a 450?
Yeah,
BR-450. I mean, it's, it pulls. He started up in the first pull. Awesome, man. Dude, appreciate it, dude.
Hey, no problem, buddy.
Dude, I mean, I'd offer him a burrito, but he was like, no, I don't eat burritos. It's bad for his digestion, so. No, but, man, dude, appreciate it, brother.
Hey, no
man.
Problem, bro.
So I'm definitely going to use this. I'm going to use it, man. And it's funny because I was telling Eddie that yesterday I went to one of my properties and their entire front yard was covered in leaves. And there was no way I was going to be able to do it with the small Ryobi. And then he hits me up. When did you hit me up? Last night, right?
Yeah.
Okay, he hit me up last night. He was like, hey, dude, I got another blower. I'll give it to you. I'll meet you in Dallas. I was like, what? So it's definitely a blessing, man. So we definitely appreciate it, brother. Thank you, man.
Not a problem.
So we'll definitely we'll use it. We're going to use it tomorrow. We have to. And shout out to his son, Cole. I know he said that he watches my videos, his son. Shout out. Thank you, Cole. Thank you, Eddie, for the blower. We'll definitely put it to use. We're going to put it to use here. And let's take some footage of me blowing the leaves.
Muy bien, mucho trabajo, güey. Mucho trabajo.
Sí.
All right, y'all, check it out. So this is the BR-450. Shout out to Fast Eddie's once again. As you can see it, it did phenomenal, right? That little blower did. And here we're using the Honda HRX 217 VKA. This is it's not a commercial. I guess it would be just a consumer type mower, but it's a beast. I'm telling you guys, it's a beast. Purchase it at a local dealership. They had a sale for $604, but you could actually get it at Home Depot for $630. Love Hondas. It mulches. It does what it's supposed to do. It cuts. And this is a mower that I would definitely recommend to you guys that are starting your lawn care business. If you want to know what type of mower, I would go with it. Okay, I'm not getting paid. Another property that we're using this mower. Of course, I'm doing all the perimeters first. I usually do about 42 width of perimeter first. That way, I'll have enough room to turn around and I don't hit the fence when I go for my turnaround. This is an awesome mower, guys. Especially with you guys that are thinking of starting a business. Maybe you got your stimulus check. And I would recommend this mower. I would recommend just a really good gas-powered handheld mower. Or not a handheld mower, but blower. Like the BG56 or 86 from Steel. Or even the Echo. Or even the Toro brand. Any of that would be perfect. And get you a... like a $230 weed eater from Echo, Steel, whatever. I wouldn't recommend getting like a, stay away from the battery power for these type of equipment for now. But I don't know if you could tell, but we're really getting after it with this Honda mower. Thank you guys for everybody who's helped your brother out. We're getting back on our feet slowly but surely. What else? I got plans to also get a standard mower. I didn't want to get into debt this year, but I don't know. I'm going to wait. If I do get me a stand on, it's definitely going to be a Scag. Unless somebody just happens to give me, you know, a commercial stand on or whatever, just a good stand on, I'll take it. But other than that, I really don't want to get into debt. Push mowing is not too bad. And I do have another surprise, but won't get there until I put that video out. So as you can see, it basically does what it needs to do. I believe we're cutting at a 2-inch. This is Bermuda. Of course, Bermuda, you can mow shorter than this. And we'll see as we get closer to the camera how well it cuts, and it does mulch as you've seen the previous clip. But I do recommend this mower here for anybody that's, even if you're a homeowner and you want a good, reliable push mower, this is definitely the way to go. Tried the Toro Recycler, they just feel really cheap. The cutting quality, I guess it's okay. My dad had he went through two of them, within a year, and they just went bad. So I don't know if that was just negligence on his part or it was just the mower, but I've never had any issues with these mowers. Of course, what you got to keep in mind, guys, that if you do buy one of these mowers, the warranty is void. If you do commercial work with it, that's only the downside about this. Especially if you buy it at a dealer, local dealership. But if you go to Home Depot and get you a mower, they don't even care. So if I had a choice, I should have just bought it at Home Depot. You know, it would have just set me off about $30. But you know, they're not too particular if you use it for just home use or commercial use. But yeah, this is the 21-inch next light variable speed 4-in-1 gas walk behind self-propelled mower with selective drive control. Like I mentioned, right now they have it for $630. This ain't a commercial, okay, guys? Not a commercial. But if you guys are wondering where I got it or where you can get it, Home Depot is the place, yo. But no, I mean, it just zips into these tall weeds, grassy weeds, like nothing. I mean, it's not bad at all. Not bad at all. I don't know, guys. I think I should make... Man, I love the sound of a mower, especially when I'm asleep. I like to kind of crank up some mower sound. So I may make this track right here a sleep aid for you guys. What do you guys think? I think that'll be awesome. So we got one more stripe. Y'all guys let me know in the comments if I should loop this sound, and I'll put it up on my channel and you guys can use it to fall asleep. That would be awesome, dude. Alright, guys, please like, subscribe. See you later.
Alright, so I got a couple of bigger properties of mine that I gotta mow this morning, guys. So I got this demo from one of the Scag reps here in the area. So you guys know that I'm looking into getting a stand-on. So I've already tried the right mower, which you guys seen in my previous video. I didn't like it, and I'll explain why I didn't like it as we go. But we have the Scag 36. Now, they didn't have the 32, which is the one that I want. But either way, they got the 36. It's close. I just want to see the cutting quality and also the drivability, how it does on a lawn. So this will give me a pretty good idea on how the 32 Scag will ride. So I know a lot of you guys are always saying you need to get yourself a Scag, get you a commercial mower. Well, there you go. So like I said, more than likely, I think I'm gonna try this one. I tried the Gravely 32, drove it in the parking lot at one of the other dealerships, and it's also awesome. I mean, it was cool. I love the way it drove. The controllers were buttery smooth. But of course, I didn't get to use it on a lawn or cut grass with it. So we're gonna take this out. I'll show you guys some footage of it. and let's get moving.
Okay, we're here with the guys. We got a Baby Taco, and we got Mr. Rico Suave. They're gonna take care of this property for me. They're gonna do the flower bed, clean the flower beds, trim the hedges, the shrubs, trim also some of the crepe myrtles here, just the bottom part, right?
Muy bien, mucho trabajo, güey. Mucho trabajo.
Sí. So we got the front and we got the backyard. Let's go say hello to Mr. Rico Suave. ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó?
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Bien, bien.
¿Todo bien?
Sí, sí.
Hey, tenemos mucho trabajo hoy.
Mucho trabajo. Ahora es un holiday. Today's a holiday. Ahora es un holiday.
¿De qué?
¿De qué? Puro jale, bro. Holiday.
Yeah, man, it feels good to be out here in the field again working today. And, yeah, I did hear what happened to the trailer, and, you know, that's messed up. Those people don't get karma. But you know what's really weird? I don't see why Mr. Mark's still talking Spanish to Mr. Richard. Does he not know he knows English?
All right, guys. Well, we came over here to the one of my apartment property that I got a Mr. Richard. Y'all guys remember Mr. Richard, right? So, but for some reason, he has his trimmer there. Let's go see if we can't try to find this boy. So he looks like he left his apple here. Let me move it out of the way. We don't want somebody to run over it or steal it or jack it. So I think Mr. Richard.
Hola.
Hey, ¿qué pasó, compa?
Break.
Oh, break. ¿Qué estás mirando?
Oh, mirando el eclipse.
Eclipse en el YouTube. En el YouTube. Okay. Well, Mr. Richard is taking a break. ¿Ya comiste tacos, lonchi?
Muchos tacos.
Okay, está bien. Okay.
He's looking at the recent video I posted up with him on there, and I don't know if he's impressed. I haven't seen him smile or
I don't know if he's laughing.
I can't tell if he's. I don't think he's impressed. You think he's impressed? I don't think he's impressed at all. Let's see. I don't see a reaction out of him. Maybe he's not impressive. He likes it. Bueno.
Bueno.
He likes it, guys. He likes it.
So we got Mr. Richard posting up on that wall again. Mr. Richie, necesitas algo, bro?
No,
algo?
Todo bien, gracias.
Un drink para... You good?
No, estoy bien.
Estás bien? Okay. Are you sure you don't need a battery charger for that phone, bro? Because you've been on that phone all day, bro. Bien, que bien. Estás bien.
Oh,
all right, bro.
Gracias.
Muy bien. Mucho trabajo, güey. Mucho trabajo.
Sí. All right, guys. We're here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. I'm waiting for an Oklahomie. You guys already know who he is. I'm just going to show his face. And you guys already know who he is. Well, this brother, call him K-Town, hooked your brother up with a walk behind mower. That's all I'm going to say. He told me, hey bro, come all the way down from Dallas to Tulsa. I got a mower for you, man. We're going to see. I don't know. Could it be a toy mower? Could it be a push mower? 21 inch? Could it be a Scag? Could it be a Wright? Who knows, right? But we're about to find out. I got the trailer, barely got the trailer this morning. It took me, it's probably almost 3 p.m. I'm gonna get the mower, then I'm gonna shoot back home to Dallas. Another 5 hours, 5.5 hours, guys. But we're waiting for K-Dog here at this church. He's gonna let me, maybe we'll try out some mowing here, guys. I'm excited, man. I was excited. He told me, called me yesterday night. I was like, bro, come and get it whenever you can. Boom, wham, bam. Thank you, ma'am. I said, yes, sir. Let's do it. I couldn't even sleep last night. I was ready to rock and roll, but my trailer just got back from being repaired, and it was ready for me this morning at 8, so I couldn't come over here to Tulsa, Oklahoma until I got the trailer. So we didn't get on the road till about 9-ish or so. So I'm excited. Hey, what's up, guys? I'm over here at Tulsa, Oklahoma, and got this good looking guy right here. I don't know whose beard is better, but
cheers, man. You get all the gray in it. It looks good.
We got Kevin with Lawn Care Juggernaut, and he just blessed your boy with, let's check it out, man. A 52 inch, was it? No, 54 inch.
walk behind. And this is a trim star by Hustler. Man, he called me up yesterday and he was like, bro, I got a mower for you. If you come down to Tulsa, come and pick it up. And I'm here. Appreciate it, brother.
Yeah, I'm glad I was able to help. I mean, he said he was, you know, in his video, he said his stuff got stolen. I definitely relate with that. And, you know, I figured I was in a situation where I was able to bless somebody with a mower. I said I was going to give one away, so might as well give it to somebody that's actually going to put it to work.
We'll definitely put it to work. You guys know, I think I'm going to get some acre properties. I got two right now that I just put in bid. So, man, I think this is going to come in.
Yep.
Super handy, man, but I appreciate it, dude. Well, what's your channels, bro?
Lawn Care Juggernaut. I mean, if you want to be bored, the Boring Channel is where it's at.
There you go. The Lawn Care Juggernaut and the Boring Channel. And we're going to go ahead and give this baby a name.
Let him know what you want to call him. Are you taking offers on names? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, we'll do that. Suggestions. We'll take suggestions. So if you guys have a name for this beast right here. Of course, it can't be baby cakes, but maybe Buttercup. I don't know. Y'all guys let me know in the comments, man.